Then next to that was the, late years later became the Lincoln Trust, where the city hall is now. And going down the street becomes the Gilpin House. And at that time had a high section of rail porch in front of it. There's some of the books around town still show it. And you could see the long bar there, the bar in the Whiteman's counter. And that archway that the bank closed in is where the horse and wagon got the beer barrels in. And passing there become Charles Grocery Store. And it had a cabinet out on the street much like Platt's. And then you come to White's Alley, and White's Ice Cream. That was the mecca for everybody in the streets. We're going down the street, we had dozens of people going down, but just as many coming back from the work. And you knew each other or related to them one way or another. And you could get a, what they call an over the top in White's Ice Cream Store, which included everything on the counter for a quarter. That is, if you have a quarter. We go down to Chase's store and then to Platt's store, and on the opposite corner, Greenland's drugstore, down the street, the Challenger's drugstore. And the Platt's grocery store, you had another half of it for shoe store. And past Walman's tailor shop, and to the Jessup House, and to the Star Hotel, which was owned and operated by Fred Geiger's father. And on the other side, what we call Clouds Road, Morris Kelly dubbed it Chinatown because there was a Chinese laundry there by New Sink in one of those houses. So we got to the corner of Atlanta to get third of the Strand, the $1 Strand. It was Farmer's Bank. At that time, there were brownstone steps run up the one side and down the other side. The entrance was on the Dollar Street. That's the Rogers place. Across the street was the Jefferson House. And I remember Charlie Salvador, my first remembrance of Jefferson House, and they were bakers. But running out the rear end of the Jefferson House was a baker shop, and on top of it was another railing area with a roof over it when dances and other entertainment was held. And finally arrived at 50 McIntyre's New Castle Gazette. Before that was Western Union. Now I'm opposite B. Kind's coal yard. I'm to the office and the weighing station and the long row of sheds. Mr. Foundation was still there, you can see, where he kept the horses and the dump carts to where we kids used to change our clothes to go swimming off the Delaware Street Wharf. At that time it's about 35 feet of water, so I mean what. And finally, the white line. Well, the Erickson line and the Thomas Clyde, the steamer used to pick up Sunday school pickings at the wharf and let them go on the same beach for the picnic day. Then the White Line Ferry Company drove to Pennsville before the Wilson line went off on Chestnut Street. Now that about concludes my walk up.